Will's journey started when he was born. On day four, he started having seizures in the hospital. They weren't sure what was causing them, put him on medication, sent him home thinking that they would pass. After about 3 months, we found that he started having quite severe seizures and was admitted to the Children's Hospital for investigation. He stayed there pretty much the whole first year of his life. Will had every test under the sun. He had biopsies, his skin was sent to other parts of the world to try and find an answer for what was causing this sort of catastrophic appearance of seizures, but they found no answers. You know, the symptoms that he was having, we couldn't help him. That was really hard as a parent not to be able to help. It took 14 years to get his diagnosis, which is a long time. We call it the diagnostic journey. Usually the average time of finding out a diagnosis when you've got a rare disease is about 4.5 years, so Will's a little bit longer than that. SCN2A is an extremely unknown condition in the community. There's probably about 40 people in Australia that have it, roughly. Everyone with Will's condition can present in a different way, and it's really important for the research to find out how that works and ways in which to help families that present differently.
SCN2A is a gene that encodes one of the major proteins in the human brain, and it actually regulates how our brain works. So it regulates excitability, we say. But we only learned in the past 10 years with the development of next generation technologies for sequencing that this is actually a cause of those rare diseases where children like Will are born with seizures or have seizures early in life and then also have their development impaired. I think we are only at the beginning of understanding what is actually going on in these rare disorders.
Not having a diagnosis is a huge gap for parents, not only for the child in terms of their medical treatment, but it's a real gap for parents not having others that understand what's going on.
Kris, Will's mum, reached out to me telling me about Rare Diseases Day, something which I knew absolutely nothing about, but I'm so pleased they did. So I went to visit Will, I went to visit Kris, and to hear a little bit about their circumstance. I've learned that not all rare diseases fit into one neat box. They're rare because there are particular circumstances that affect particular families. If Kris didn't reach out to me, we wouldn't be having this conversation now. We wouldn't be drawing attention to the fact that there are people in our community with rare diseases.
So Will's 19 now. His health's stable, but he has ongoing disabilities, which means that he will struggle to live an independent life and will need ongoing support for the rest of his life. One of his passions is Highland cows, and he wants to be a farmer. I don't know what it is, but there's something peaceful and therapeutic about these cows for Will. He's actually an extremely passionate kid about the things that he loves.
The best thing that people can do today is open up a Google browser, throw in Rare Diseases Day into that Google browser and find out a bit about it themselves.
We need to raise awareness about rare diseases and advocate for access to services and also treatment plans so that they can lead their best lives. It's really important.